Good to see you, buddy.
Good to see you, too. And something we want to talk about today, you already know this, you know, a lot of people love to go to antique stores,
oh, yes,
to flea markets, even auctions on the weekend. Well, I'm going to tell you, if you're ever in the Shawnee area, it is worth your time to check out a place that's called the Rogers Vintage Depot.
Ooh, let's take a look.
All right.
We have antiques, vintage, home decor, furniture, advertising, just a whole array of vintage and antiques.
But Rogers Vintage Depot is actually more than that. They have what I would call an eclectic mix of history you can see and touch. The key word is in the name of the store, vintage. Kimberly, the owner, has a gift and passion for finding the right items for her customers, and her customers love shopping here.
Everything is cool about this place. I shop here for just about anything I can think of that's vintage. I've gotten old windows here and old bottles, and I like to decorate my home with a mix of vintage and new. So anytime I have an idea of something I want, I come here and I always find it.
Many of us find it appealing to retrieve a small portion of the past by acquiring a material piece of it. Rogers Vintage Depot is a place where you can recapture a valued memory.
Which one do you like?
I want this one.
Like a toy from one's childhood, and then share that with your grandson.
For me, I love just coming and looking at all the old things and reminiscing about a lot of the stuff I had as a little kid growing up in North Carolina. It's neat to be able to show him toys that I played with as a little kid and try to explain it, and a lot of them he will like and laugh at.
As the owner, Kimberly gravitates toward the metal toys and advertising pieces.
That's a very cool store. You're going to have to check it out.
We are going to check it out.
And whatever you charge, tell your wife I'm sorry.
Now you can see that this weekend, right?
That's right. The rest of that story, plus we'll tell you about a place in Del City that's serving up some unique egg rolls.
Oh, that sounds good too. You got us set up, brother.
Yeah, I'm telling you.
What else is happening this Valentine's weekend?
Well, we're going to talk about tragic romance, and that's because Romeo and Juliet is back on stage. Oklahoma Shakespeare in the Park opens this season. Their season tonight with multiple showings. This is at 2920 Paseo. You can buy tickets online for $35 each, but they do offer a variety of discounts. You can express your love for horsepower at the Monster Jam at the Chesapeake Energy Arena tomorrow and Sunday. There's something new this year. There is a pit party on Sunday from 10:30 a.m. until noon where you can see the trucks up close and get autographs from your favorite drivers. Tickets are $15. Mm-hmm. And finally, in honor of Black History Month, there is a free Oklahoma African American Family Film Festival Saturday. This is at the Oklahoma History Center. This includes films, videos, even some raw, unedited footage documenting the history and culture of the African American experience in our state. This is Saturday from noon until 5. So You're going to be doing some shopping this weekend.
I think we may have to, yeah, do a little bit of that down in Shawnee.
That's right. Cool. That's right.
We go way back. It's always good to see you.
Always good to see you, too.
Thanks, Dino.
You bet.
Have a great weekend.
You too.
You can watch Dino and Discover Oklahoma at 5 p.m. on Saturdays right after our 6 o'clock newscast.